I will use a simple simulator called Compass MR to explain magnetic resonance MR used for MRI at hospitals and for chemical analysis. The simulator runs directly in any browser and it allows you to explore the MR phenomenon. First, I will focus on the atomic nuclei which emit the signal visualized in magnetic resonance imaging MRI. Some atomic nuclei are magnetic. This is the case for hydrogen, which is present in water molecules. The hydrogen nuclei have spins similar to that of the spinning ball seen here. It is a charged particle, so you basically have a current running in a loop and you get electromagnetism. The simple consequence of this is that atomic nuclei largely behave like compass needles. Each nucleus is magnetic with a north pole and a south pole. I will introduce a magnetic field in the vertical direction. The north pole of the hydrogen nucleus is attracted to the south pole here, and the south pole of the nucleus is attracted to the north pole down here. The two magnets create a strong magnetic field, B0, in the vertical direction. The nuclear spin is here aligned along that axis. If given a push, the nucleus will oscillate in the magnetic field. This is measured during MRI, and it is the intensity of that oscillation that is shown in MRI images. Before discussing nuclear magnetic resonance, I will introduce a simpler but similar phenomenon called compass magnetic resonance. Initially, you see a compass needle aligned along the magnetic field. When given a push, it will oscillate before it comes to rest, pointing along the direction of the field. Here, one full oscillation of the needle takes approximately 2 seconds. The oscillation frequency is therefore around half a hertz. The relaxation time is seen to be around 10 seconds. As long as the needle vibrates, it generates an oscillating magnetic field that we can detect with a coil. The induced coil voltage is the MR signal that here disappears on a timescale of 10 seconds. You see the FID down here. We cannot push atomic nuclei this way. The challenge is therefore to make the signal without touching the needle. For this, we need a second magnetic field perpendicular to the strong B0 field. We call this weak field for B1. The B1 field pushes one end of the needle and pulls the other. Since B1 is weak compared to B0, it just rotates the needle slightly. When the B1 field is removed, the needle resumes its direction along the B0 field. This vibration is too weak to generate a satisfactory signal. We need to make the needle oscillate more. This can be accomplished by repeatedly pushing the compass needle with the B1 field. Like this. We pursue this idea by making the B1 field oscillate. Our first attempt here is not very successful. The needle does vibrate, but only slightly, and the signal is therefore weak. We can improve the situation much if we adjust the frequency of the B1 field to the natural vibration frequency of the compass needle. Repeated weak pushes can have a large effect when applied in synchrony with the natural oscillation. This is the resonance condition. Use the same principle when you push a child in a swing. When applied to magnetic resonance, the B1 field pushes the compass needle in synchrony with its natural oscillation. The weak B1 field only has a large effect when the resonance condition is met. When doing MR measurements, we interleave excitation periods with measurement periods. I therefore now turn off the B1 field. I measure the signal while it decays away due to relaxation. You have seen a basic MR experiment, but there is a practical problem when we want to apply this to the nuclear compass needle. The problem is that atomic nuclei oscillate millions of times per second, and it is not practical to move a magnet at that rate. This is solved by not only using the coil for detection, but also for excitation. If we send a current through a coil, it becomes magnetic, as illustrated by the coloring of the coil. If we apply an alternating current, it can push and pull the compass needle in synchrony with its natural oscillation, and we see magnetic resonance once again. So I am exciting now, and then I just B1 down, and then I measure. This is called the pulse acquire experiment, and I can do it again. So currently we are measuring, and now I switch to excitation, and then I switch back to measurement. This concludes the demonstration of compass magnetic resonance, and I now return to nuclei MR. You here see the nuclear compass needle aligned with the B0 field. There are differences to compass MR, but the main principles are unchanged. The nuclear magnetization does not move quite like a normal compass needle due to spin. Before demonstrating this, I want to point out that the consequences are limited. If nuclei behaved exactly like compass needles, it would still be possible to do MRI, even using the scanners of today unchanged. Spin was discussed already. It is the rotation of the nuclei that is responsible for making them magnetic. This nuclear rotation is always present and independent of the magnetic field. A second kind of nuclear rotation appears when we push the nucleus away from the equilibrium position. The compass needle vibrated in a plane about the B0 direction, but the nuclear magnetization rotates around B0 instead. This motion is characteristic of rapidly rotating objects. It is called precession and is known from spinning tops that slowly precesses around the gravitational field. The precession around B0 becomes more apparent when I now excite the nucleus further with the help of a resonant B1 field. The important result is that we can rotate the nucleus to point in any direction we wish by applying a resonant magnetic field. Here I switch the B1 field on sufficiently long to rotate the magnetization 90 degrees away from equilibrium. This finishes the demonstration. You are encouraged to explore compass and nuclear magnetic resonance further by visiting the link here. The Compass MR simulator runs directly in any browser and is also available as a free app. This is useful whenever you need to explore or explain magnetic resonance. If you are familiar with MR, you may wonder why quantum mechanics was not mentioned in this introduction. You can find the explanation in the menu. Here. This will bring you to a web page discussing the relation between classical and quantum descriptions of MR. You will also find links to the more advanced block simulator that can help you gain more insight into MRI.